A lot of serious stuff going on here for side-by-sides. There's also a lot of unserious stuff going on in building 2.
Yeah,
we're coming. Hold on. I'm shooting a promo. Listen, guys. It's almost time to finish this giveaway. The Tyrannosaurus Flex. We got this hoodie. We got all sorts of other good stuff. You guys can see it on the site. See on thebigend.com. Every order is going to have a chance to win a UDR.
Whoa.
We bought 5 of them. They're not here yet. And there's nothing in this. Look at this. That one's empty.
Oh.
But the boxes we're shipping to you will be full of UDRs. So 5 of you guys that bought from this giveaway will be able to enter that. And one of you guys will have a chance to win my TRX, a 2022 X3, 2022 trailer, or 100 grand cash. Pretty
nice.
That's
a lot.
See you on thebigend.com. Right now, we're going to see you in building2.com.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so things are getting pretty serious here at Building 2. Matt has spent a lot of time organizing all our OEM parts.
It doesn't look like it, but...
Yeah,
we have a lot of little parts.
Tons.
That I'm trying to get through.
This is like the yellowest zone. I feel like I have jaundice in here, but I don't. It's just the poor lighting. But over here We have what you'd call somewhat of like an industrial off-road crawling park. Come check this out. So this is the first part here. These are kind of all old pieces and parts from things that we've used in this shop and other shops. This is a dyno television. I'll be honest with you.
Still just sitting there.
I lied to you. That was me.
You lied to me?
Yeah,
look at this.
I didn't.
You're
know
the
that
only
was
person
TV.
That would use a 75-inch TV.
I thought
for a rock crawling course.
I thought it was the glass top to a table. Look at it.
Okay.
Which I thought, no big deal. I can
it's
drive
just
a
got
little truck on
vents and plugs and anyway, it doesn't matter.
See all that stuff. I'm out here rock crawling. Anyway, so this is what we got. These are Traxxas TRX4s. These are both what, like a hot lift style, they call them?
They're like, trail bosses.
Yeah,
sure. You can see now, 2.2s.
2.2s with a 5.5-inch wheel. They got the extensions.
That's not what we're trying to do here. Kind of like the UDRs, I take a more basher approach with everything. Nick Seuss takes a little more of a controlled approach. Results are the same. Hold on, I'll come help you out, buddy.
Don't need it. Oh, my dingus!
I'll get it. All right, so yeah, these are pretty interesting. They have high and low range, so they have a gearbox built in, and they also have open center diff and open rear differential, locked center diff, and then locked every diff, which is pretty freaking awesome to have.
Oh yeah,
we got it. All right, so we're on to the webbing here. And then for a steering radius, I like to sometimes unlock the diff through the course.
Oh yeah, definitely get better steering that way.
Yeah.
With them open.
Jumping it? Okay.
Put her in high and let it fly.
Wow, that was awesome. Nice.
Okay, all right.
Oh. All right, my turn. All right, here we go.
Nice.
Oh.
That one's really tough across the Rhino ramp.
Got
it. Yeah, no problem. Down the Rhino ramp.
This is why I took my front end of the bumper out for this section.
Wow, look at that approach angle.
Oh no, I just fell off.
Oh, yeah.
You're good.
This one is impossible.
So, because we can't make it this way, this course was actually intended to go that way.
Yeah, let's just start with Couch Mountain.
But Couch Mountain's a fun place.
Yeah, it's over there by Livernois Lane.
Yeah, we won't...
I'll hit it one shot.
Oh.
That's how tough these things are.
It's pretty tough.
Like,
oh, like butter.
Oh! Oh, boy. Now this one here, you pretty much have to do a stoppie going down.
Oh, no. can't see.
What are you doing?
I can't see. It's this angle.
Man, you guys are not pros.
Mike, you're never gonna make it.
Yeah, we gotta fix that.
You're never gonna make it, bud.
We gotta fix that. All right, Mike.
Push him. Push him.
What do we got here? That's a weird looking crawling course.
Yeah, this is actually a crawling course made out of a two-stroke swap X3 on tracks and skis. Who would have thought that was going to be a thing?
Maybe you need a little helper here?
Yeah, just get me up there. Wow.
You trying to kill me?
Maybe this is better suited to be used somewhere else.
Somewhere with snow.
Perhaps
we don't have one of those.
Snowy field, which we don't have.
Yeah. Unfortunate.
You want to drive it anyway or what?
I think so. I would like to drive it to bash that front end around and just see if it's going to instantly fold or if it's going to work before we take it 6 hours right now. It looks pretty good. I have some confidence, but...
You should explain all the stuff that you did because it's not really clear looking at it.
All right, first thing, pretty simple and obvious, right? We made the strut. So the way the ski mounts the strut is like a basic snowmobile. It pivots here. It's got a flat plate with some rubber dampers under it. So the ski, you know, can't go crazy, but it can articulate like it's supposed to. It's bolted in through two wheel studs. Okay, maybe not enough, but then it's also bolted in through the main hub.
Which is enough.
I think so. And like this is quarter inch thick, like heavy wall, you know, 2 inch steel tubing. The issue with that is you can't have the whole thing just twisting, right? It's just gonna twist underneath the machine and explode. So in order to lock the hub out and keep it in position, we've come in and just welded these two tabs right to the outer stub axle that we've got in there. That's probably the most questionable part of this whole setup, I think. So I think it should be okay though. I mean, it's bolted in through the caliper bracket bolts, right? Those gotta be pretty strong.
I would think.
You're smashing on the brakes, skidding the tires, those things don't break off. So I think we're gonna be okay. That stuff's pretty thick, got a lot of weld on there. Who's to say, really?
I think it'll work.
I'm fairly confident.
I think with Mike Reed's jumping from the last video, we just got to send this sucker over the jump, dude. Just really make sure it's going to be good for the snow. What do you say, man?
I'm going to pass on that one.
Yeah, we should drive it. And then maybe you can hit the new jump, too, with your side-by-side, dude.
You should probably hit that new jump.
It's a good jump.
Do you know he has a side-by-side? You have a side-by-side?
I forgot.
Nope, gave it up, dude. I'm here strictly for RC. And
that 900 Razor, that orange one.
Yeah, the orange one.
I just saw a video of that sucker doing freaking Devil's Hole, or what's that thing called?
Hot Tub.
Hot Tub, go for it through. Should have never got rid of that machine. Good for you, good for you.
I'm a professional crawler, dude. Just act like a psycho.
Oh, I don't know what happened.
What a dong, dude.
Uni,
the official air filter of everybody with a Banshee. Go ahead.
Come on, Electron.
Come on, baby.
We got it.
Still coming, Norm.
Oh, yeah.
Just took off through the garage door. I thought that was gonna happen for sure. So if you drive it, those will just stick in the dirt, and then you can just take right off.
Yeah, ideally we'll just get it out of the shot. The wheels fly out.
This will be sick. All right. First time ever, dude. The snowmobile X3. We might want
to adjust the front end to put a little more caster in the spindles, because once they load up, they kind of straighten out.
Oh, so you want them more like
me? Maybe that'll be okay. I was trying to keep them in line with the ball joints, but we'll just see how it works.
Yeah, just drive her around, dude. Unit. So yeah, this is kind of the problem we're talking about with that. Your effective gearing is controlled by that little plastic deal on the back. So up until about 40, this thing's awesome. What the hell? It looks like it handles really good.
Come on, go over it. Go over it.
Here we go.
I mean, it's working pretty good.
You know, we know the top speed with these tracks is not high.
Yeah.
So that's always a bit of a bummer. But I mean, we ran it through some ruts, up and over the jump a couple times, and the front end hasn't fallen off yet. So
that's all you need.
Pretty happy with that.
Well, that's the cone of a legend right there, and that legend is MFR.
Don't underestimate it. Seuss might pull something out here. We maybe get some distance on this thing still, so.
Yeah, that one that you sent before it was knocked down was insane.
Awesome. I was scared, and after jumping that a few times, that car took it so well.
Yeah, yeah.
So well.
Side-by-side blog jump master, Nick Seuss, is coming in. Those things jump so good. It did nose out, though.
Hold on. He was right here.
I mean, the discrepancy between you guys is incredible.
I'm going to say it was right here.
Yeah, well, I don't know what
you're
seeing, dude.
Also wasn't paying that much attention.
All right, his glove box is closed now. He can go fast. It might be too short. Matt, you are blind, dude. He didn't. He never landed there.
I wasn't straight. I'm sorry. It's all about perspective.
Whoa, wild line.
Wow, crazy line.
It's basically the same spot every time, right there. We are not.
Hey.
It's nosing down pretty good.
You put it in Baja mode?
Yeah.
Did you put it in rock mode?
Maybe I'll try it.
Did you put it in comfort mode?
Maybe I'll try and track and level me out.
Oh, yeah.
It's not like a dangerous nose, but it's nosing.
All right, you put it in track mode. Slightly better.
Maybe a little better, yeah.
All right, maybe that line is starting to become accurate.
Okay, I was out there.
It's not getting better with speed.
Why are you trying to hit me?
It's not getting better.
Is this
better.
Because of the RC cars?
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Jump it this way, and then let's see if you can break the ball joints.
Nah, we're good.
Aww.
Nah.
Dang it.
Frank, I need a little more length, dude.
I don't need, we need some more dirt.
Some more dirt.
I got, dude, we got you 10 acres of dirt. Just grab some.
I'm not sure if you know what we found in the dirt, but it rhymes with Blat Blive Blable.
Johnny Walker Black Label?
Show him, Doug.
Network.
I don't think it's important. It, you know, it's not.
Well, that's not good.
Keep her going. Let's see where it goes.
There you go. Just pull it all out.
What if consumers ran that cable and didn't tell us?
Hook it to the back of the two-stroke, and then we'll just pull it out.
Ooh, she just hit something hard there. Might be a root.
Oh! That's all right. Now we know where it's at, though, because it's pulled out way longer.
Rebury it.
That's pretty much what they did when they put it in.
Yeah.
Nick Seuss is making his order, dude, on cnthebigun.com with a fake name, Blickless Blues.
No,
he's
dude.
Trying to win my truck so he can have power finally.
I'll take that truck, dude. I'll sell it. I'll buy two Raptors. Oh, we can't talk
anymore. You can't even get one Raptor.
cnthebigun.com.
Yeah, he's got it.
Yeah! Boy, it doesn't look as fast as the Pro, but it sounds cool. Alright, here we go. Yeah. It's just so weird looking.
Reach his ass.
You gotta hype him up, dude. Hype him up. Here he comes, boys. Oh, man.
That thing works great.
That lands great. Checkers or wreckers, boys. Checkers or wreckers. Come on, Doug.
Come on.
That thing is hilarious.
Excellent. It's okay. It's getting a little warm again. We got an air pocket in the air system for sure. We got to sort out. That's an easy one. But man, if it can take that, like in the snow where the skis actually slide and aren't just sticking and everything, I think it'd be good. We could send this thing.
We could probably use this to bury Cat 5. I think that's what Dow used. If you think about it, it's relatively similar marks.
Just trencher, man.
Wow, that is awesome. I'm glad it worked. It held up just fine. I didn't see any issues.
You were soaring through there. Very weird to see. It felt very weird.
It looked very weird. I think she's good, Frank.
A few moments later.
100% we bent the lower arm.
Okay. Really?
Yep.
That little tangus
if you stand over this, the lower ball joint is slightly ahead of the upper.
Yeah.
If you stand over this one, the lower ball joint is behind the upper.
It doesn't look really bent. Is this a bent chassis? You never know.
Yeah, just straighten them back and put a little gusset on them.
Dude, Huckers, Rick, get us some 3/8 plate stat, dude.
Nothing like unsprung weight.
Yeah, it'll be perfect for this thing.
All in all, I think you did an excellent job. That was sweet. I didn't expect it to jump through the air today. And you did it 18 times, maybe 19 times. Leo ran out of freaking video. Okay.
Yeah.
We did it so many times.
Yeah. This is a fresh card.
That was sweet. Good job.
Thanks, man. I think proof of concept is a success. Okay. Lower arm. That's a weak point.
Yeah.
We
can
fix that easy. We've been there, done that. So.
Yeah. But are you gonna go that hard in snow? And if you do, you have snow to catch you. Boom. Got it. You're good.
I guess I'm not surprised you already broke it. Couldn't find reverse. You gotta put it in reverse before you put it in reverse.
Now use this kind of brand.
Oh boy. Gonna lose another finger. fuckers loud, dude.
Yeah, they're locked up, dude.
Wow.
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 Yeah. Leaking all sorts of stuff. Oh, yeah. That's probably Mountain Dew in the cooling system. Looks like it, at least. Two-stroke, dude.
Oh, this leaking coolant, eh? Okay.
That means it's got some in it.
Hey, we found our problem. Yeah, overall, that was tight. It's gonna work. We'll fix that arm. We'll fix whatever's going on in the coolant system there. Get her bled out. Keep her cool. And just go for a rip with this thing. We gotta figure out how to make it go faster, too.
Yeah.
Oh, there's another set of tracks, or... We have to do some real goofy stuff to gear this thing up, but anyways, I love snow. I love snowmobiles. This thing's super wacky.
Yeah.
It's tight. So, yeah, I'm in. You guys are going to see more of this thing. We're actually going to go rip it in the snow when the snow comes. So we'll get her tuned in. It's going to be real fun. Thank you guys for everything you do to support us, to allow us. Frank's already fixed it.
What happened?
It was just the loose hose clamp.
That's it. So she was probably just low on coolant.
Thank God we rehired him. Anyway.
Sucker's ready to go, man. But yeah, seriously, thank you guys so much. Don't forget, we got that big giveaway going right now. Time is running thin. Buy a little bit of merch. Get yourself some Christmas gifts. And get a chance to win a 2022 700 horsepower freaking TRX with an enclosed trailer with a brand new X3 Max RR loaded up in the back. And if you don't win that, you could still win brand new UDRs with batteries, ready to rip, chargers. I mean, we got all sorts of stuff going out. And you can also get some sweet merch in the process. So don't forget that, sucker. Thanks for everything. See you guys back here in a couple days.
I know he doesn't like saying it either.
I
forgot one thing. It's coming. You just got to put it out there. $100,000, you guys.
Oh, yeah.
This is not a scam, by the way. We've been getting this. This is legit. No, doing this. $100,000.
I'm not even going to talk about it. It's not a scam.
You giving away like surprise how many people I've gotten asked if it's a scam.
The idiots, dude.
People
not a chance.
This long, they know us. They've been around.
The only thing that's a scam, it's not going online and getting yourself some merch. That's a scam.
Whoa.
Big scam.
Give us that pose, dude.
Hold on, 1 second. Doug, just try to come out of here.
I don't know.
Just come out of here.
Come at him, dude.
What's up, man?
Whoa.
Hey, the weight room's
scary.
Down over there.
Yeah, thanks.
The big wide one.
We gotta go, dude.
Yeah, we've got enough to do.